Dear friends and followers, today I'll be answering a recently asked question. What is a windsock and how does it work?
1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, runway 27.
A windsock is a conical shaped textile tube which resembles a giant sock, hence its name, designed to indicate wind direction and relative wind speed. It's normally placed next to the runway or a helipad so that pilots can easily see it after lining up on the runway or coming in for landing. It's also indicated on most airport ground charts with this little symbol. During night operation, it is well lit either from the ground or lamps installed within the SOC. Its general purpose is to give the pilots a quick reference as to where the wind is coming from and the approximate wind speed. Before accelerating for takeoff, you take a quick glance at it so you can give the necessary rudder inputs whilst rolling down the runway. To determine the wind direction, you look at your compass, check your heading, and then estimate the pointing angle of the windsock relative to your heading. The wind direction is the opposite of the direction in which the windsock is pointing, which means if we had a wind blowing from the west at 270 degrees with 10 knots, for example, the windsock would point towards heading east because of the direction it is blowing in. I'll show you this in an example. Okay, now in this example, we're looking at the windsock out of a bird's perspective, okay? So we're looking on top of the windsock. As you can see, the wind is blowing from west towards this direction. So it's actually blowing from the west towards the east. Now, as you can see, the windsock is pointing into easterly direction. So it would be 090, but because you know the wind is coming from the other side, you just have to calculate the opposite heading of that. So that will be 270 degrees. So more or less, anywhere where the windsock is pointing, the pointing end, the opposite of that will give you your wind direction. It's as easy as that. But why does the sock have these red and white rings? They are therefore to measure the wind velocity. Each ring indicates a wind speed of 5 knots. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 knots. But in this example here, you can see that the windsock starts tilting at this point. So it's actually only two rings are fully blown up, 1 and 2, which sums up as 10 knots, and the wind isn't strong enough to fully blow up the rest of them. So this indicates a wind speed of 10 knots and not more. And that is how you read the wind speed of the windsock. So as we look at this video here, we have 1 and 2 rings fully blown up, and the last 3 are slightly tilted downwards, so that sums up 2 rings times 5 knots is respectively a wind speed of 10 knots. But at the same time, you can see that the sock sometimes is fully blown up and flapping about, so you could expect some gusts as well. In the background, I can see the runway, and knowing its heading of 260 degrees, I assume that the sock is fairly parallel to it, and so I guess the wind direction will be approximately 260 degrees. So not too bad what we have estimated, 260 degrees, 10 knots and gusts, and if we compare that to the ATIS readout, I think we got fairly close. Again, a windsock is only for a quick reference. If you want a proper wind information, you would have to listen to the ATIS.
Level 70, wind 320 degrees, 10 knots.
Or ask tail control. So you can see that they are fairly easy to interpret and a great help to get a quick wind information. They're easy to install and cheap to maintain, and it's required by flight regulations that even the smallest airport has at least one visible windsock. I hope you've enjoyed this video and I've answered another aviation related question for you. So give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel, and if you have further questions, don't hesitate to comment below. I'll be happy to answer your questions via a video blog. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Your Captain Joe. 'Look out for the windsock the next time you're sitting in your passenger seat. You will most probably see them as we taxi towards the runway. And maybe you can already guess the wind direction and the wind speed before actually taking off. So good luck with that.